5-year-old that's collapsed off a motorbike, GCS9, having seizures. He thinks it's a medical event, but they've no crews to send.
The team's being asked to help out the neighbouring East Midlands ambulance service.
Radios and lights all good. Get ready. Yeah, we're off to somewhere, I don't know where we're going. Tideswell, Peak District.
Flying Dr. Chris suspects the woman has had a brain hemorrhage.
So if you've got a reduced GCS, I think it's maybe something like a subarach. You need to consider RSI and sort of neuroprotection.
The Peak District is the UK's most popular national park. The Dam Busters trained for their famous raid in these valleys. And so did Army veteran Gary.
In the military, we used to go down this valley.
And the skies are still full of military planes.
Plane, comes up the horizon, Gary, there. Mostly left to right, eye levels, two of them.
Eye level?
Look down low, 1 o'clock, yeah, 1 o'clock, yeah, 2, yeah.
The patient is in the care of the local ground ambulance crew.
He's waving.
Yeah, that's him, yeah.
Contact for definite. Yeah. He's got red lights flashing on the back of his car.
I'm going to the field on his... Yeah, the one with no cows in, basically.
Gary's landing his team yards from the battle to save the woman.
Okay, we're down, leave his ankle clear out.
Cheryl Harding had just left her home for a bike ride with her partner Jack when she collapsed.
Yeah, yeah. So, 45-year-old lady, just left home, just at the end of the road, little wobble on a motorbike, and then fell sideways, unresponsive since then.
For Dr. Chris, her symptoms are very concerning.
Hello, Cheryl. Cheryl, my name's Chris, I'm one of the doctors. You all right there? Cheryl? Can you open your eyes? I'm just going to pinch her on the shoulder, OK? Cheryl? Open your eyes.
She's deeply unconscious.
GCS is fairly low. Eye opening is a 2. Verbal response is a 2. And motors are best about probably a 3. So 2, 2, 7. Breathing patterns can appear to be a bit slow. I think she's probably the 9, isn't it?
Cheryl and Jack are keen bikers and enjoy the lifestyle that goes with it.
I know she's got piercings up here. Has she got any piercings in her mouth?
No.
So nothing in her tongue?
No.
Several passers-by stopped to help Cheryl.
Just followed the lady and got halfway down the road. She seemed a bit wobbly on a bike. And then she came up to here and her partner pulled out of the junction and he went to the road. And then she sort of like what we thought, she'd stalled it, and then she fell off the bike and she fell to her side and the bike landed on the side. And then she was basically lay on the side of the road. So obviously we stopped like and made see it's sure right. We thought she'd just fallen off, but she'd, obviously had a fit or something like that. We're not sure what yet.
There are a number of conditions that could have caused Cheryl's collapse. All of them are serious.
So we're going to put this lady off to sleep. This is a fairly sort of heavy-duty procedure and you know, not without risk. So we need to make sure everything's prepared beforehand so that it goes as smoothly as possible. So I'm just getting all the equipment that's required just ready on time, checking it all, making sure everything works so that when we're ready, we can just get on with it and everything should go to plan.
Dr. Chris is going to anaesthetise her here where she lies.
Oh, can I just take some morphine out of your pocket, bud?
It'll allow them to stabilise her for a flight to hospital.
Here, so head end here. We're going to be head down, but otherwise you'll be squinting in the sun.
The team are turning the side of a country road into an operating theatre.
Keep coming. Stop.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Excuse me, young man with glasses. Can I get a rolled-up blanket, please?
Yep.
Dr. Chris is enlisting all the paramedics to help in the procedure.
So I'll be the lead, I'm the intubator. You'll be my assistant. You're going to give cricoid, and Lee, you're going to give drugs. Can you also keep an eye on the monitor for me as well? Is that okay? Fine, sat's on a bit on the low side. Can you just gently bag her for me? Is that okay?
Cheryl is being paralysed so they can take over her breathing.
Keep back, squeezing that fluid.
Yeah.
A bit quicker, mate, if you can. And all that rock uranium to go in.
A tube is being slid down her windpipe so they can breathe for her.
OK, you've got the tube? OK. Right, let's get her on the ventilator. Let's finish the packaging and then let's get going.
She's now ready to fly.
Hello, it's Chris on Helimed 98 here. Can I give you a pre-alert, please?
Cheryl's brain can now rest. Dr. Chris is alerting specialists at Sheffield's Northern General Hospital, 25 miles away.
OK, is everybody ready? So we'll say ready, steady and lift, and go on lift, OK? Ready, steady, lift.
Speed is essential. The longer she waits for hospital care, the longer her life is at risk, and the more brain function she could lose if she recovers.
So we're going round the tail, so past the end of the tail, and then we'll turn back in.
As Dr. Chris suspected, it looks like she is suffering from a subarachnoid hemorrhage, a lethal bleed on the brain.
You've got blood where it shouldn't be in the brain. Part of the brain then becomes ischemic and starts to die. So in order to manage properly, we need to take very careful care of her airway. Maintain her oxygen and CO2 levels at the right within the right parameters. So the best way to do that is to take control of the breathing by putting her to sleep, which is what we've done.
Helimed 98 has been at maximum cruising speed, and Gary is determined to give his patient a smooth landing.
That was textbook, man. No, proper helipad landing. I didn't know it was landing. They're out bending the skids.
Oh, are we down?
Yeah, that's from 98.
Now, the fight to save Cheryl's life begins. She's critically ill, and saving her will require all of the Northern General's expertise. Biker Cheryl returned home to the Peak District after specialists woke her from an induced coma. But the cause of her collapse remains a medical mystery.
Well, whilst I was still under the anaesthetic, they did a CT scan, which didn't show anything at all. The only suggestion that they've made is that it may be epilepsy of some form of description. We may never know, but I'm off the road at the minute, so no biking, no car driving.
She's continuing to undergo medical tests.